Hey there, today we're going to talk about emotional eating. So here's the thing. I've often heard the term emotional eating as a negative thing, and to be honest, I totally explained myself that way, and I just, in the past when I was dieting, I just wanted to get rid of the emotional eating. I thought that the way to get rid of the problem of my weight was to avoid emotions. I didn't consciously say that or think it, but you know, that's kind of the way that I imagined it. If I had less stress in my life, then I was gonna be less of an emotional eater. But here's the thing. I've learned more now. And so honestly, knowledge can be powerful when put to use. So here's about emotional eating. Emotions aren't bad. And emotional eating is natural. We're wired that way. We're made to be emotional eaters. Without emotions, well, you wouldn't even be an eater, okay? So instead of making emotional eating wrong, I wanna make it right. And I wanna look at some different scenarios where, according to my understanding and the way I have experienced it now with a transformation with my food and my body image issues that I've had in the past, now I see there are some instances in which emotional eating is appropriate. And so I've given you some examples here, okay? Let's go ahead and zoom in here. So a few circumstances when I would say that honestly, emotional eating would be the way to go are, they're listed here. Let's look at this. So when emotional eating is the right choice, according to Jen, is when it's more stressful to avoid it than to eat it. Okay, honestly, stress is so bad for our body. When we eat in the stress state, we actually can shut down our digestion. So it's actually, in some cases, better to eat a piece of chocolate than to avoid it, because you're creating so much stress by trying to avoid it. So that's all things considered. But honestly, sometimes I found it's better to just have a little bit of what I'm craving rather than fight so hard to avoid it. And honestly, create a stress response around food. Food is our friend, not our enemy. Another instance is when you're gonna actually feel better after eating it than regret it. So in some instances, when I'm craving something, then later I regret it and I wish I hadn't eaten it, right? You know what I'm talking about. When I overeat and I one time ate, you know, half the half gallon of ice cream, that choice, I regretted it. I didn't feel good. I didn't feel good about my choice in my body, and I didn't feel good about my choice emotionally either, because I knew that I had just eaten my feelings rather than enjoyed the ice cream, right? The last one is if you're eating, it contributes to the life you want to be living. So when I was thinking of that scenario, I'm thinking of like the birthday party where, you know, in the past, sometimes I didn't even want to go to the party because I was so stressed about what I might meet there and what I might be eating. And by releasing the shame and struggle around the food, I'm now able to go to social occasions and actually enjoy the food options rather than stress about it. I actually end up eating less that way. So I just wanted to throw it out there that in what I have learned and also experienced, it is not always bad to be an emotional eater. We're supposed to be emotional, and by actually enjoying our food, we actually metabolize it better. So there is a lot we can learn around the psychology of eating, and I'd be happy to share more. Just shoot me a message, and I hope you enjoyed this.